Welcome to a video on the alternating series test for convergence. The alternating series test states, given an alternating series in one of these two forms, if the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n equals 0, notice a sub n is a non-alternating part of the formula that generates the terms in the series. And if a sub n plus 1 is less than or equal to a sub n, meaning the series is decreasing, then the alternating series does converge. So if these two conditions are met for an alternating series, the series converges. Now, I do have to be careful about interpreting this test. It is only for alternating series, and we cannot apply it to non-alternating series. Let's go ahead and take a look at some examples. The first thing we should notice is we have an alternating series because we have negative 1 raised to the power of n plus 1. This should also remind you of the harmonic series, except now this is the alternating harmonic series. Here are the two conditions that must be met in order to satisfy the alternating series test. Let's start by determining the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n. Again, a sub n would be the non-alternating part of this formula, so a sub n would be 1 over n. So the first condition is this limit must equal 0. And it does. Next, we need to make sure that a sub n plus 1 is less than or equal to a sub n. Well, a sub n plus 1 would be 1 over n plus 1, and that must be less than or equal to a sub n, which is just 1 over n. Looking at this, we can tell that this fraction has larger denominators, and therefore would always be less than or equal to 1 over n. So these two conditions are met. So by the alternating series test, the given series converges. So this is kind of interesting because the harmonic series diverges, but the alternating harmonic series converges based upon this test. Let's take a look at another alternating series. Again, our first step is to identify a sub n, which is a non-alternating part of this formula. So a sub n is going to equal 2n divided by 5n minus 3. This limit has to be equal to 0 before we can proceed with the alternating series test. And it's not. Notice the degree of the numerator and denominator are the same, so this limit is equal to the ratio of the leading coefficients, which is 2/5. So this doesn't equal 0, so it fails the alternating series test. So not only is this limit not equal to 0, it fails the nth term divergent test. So this alternating series diverges. Let's take a look at one more. So first we'll check to see to make sure this limit is equal to 0, and then we'll check to see if the non-alternating series is decreasing. So a sub n is going to equal 1 over 3 times natural log n. Again, remember that a sub n is a non-alternating part of this formula. Now we'll determine the limit as n approaches infinity. Well, our denominator increases without bound, and our numerator is fixed, so this is equal to 0. So we've satisfied the first condition for the alternating series test. And now we need to check to make sure that a sub n plus 1 is less than or equal to a sub n. Well, if this is a sub n, then a sub n plus 1 would be 1 over 3 times the natural log of n plus 1. We want to make sure this is less than or equal to a sub n, which is 1 over 3 times natural log n. Well, again, if we're adding 1 to n and then taking the natural log, these denominators will be larger than these denominators here. Therefore, these fractions will always be less than or equal to these fractions here. So both conditions are satisfied. So we can conclude from the alternating series test that the given series does converge. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.